Good morning to everyone. My name is Dr. Anand, Professor of EC Department. So in this lecture, I'm going to explain about what is capacitance and the capacitor in a spherical way, how to calculate the capacitance. So what is the, this is under the title of electromagnetic fields. The electromagnetic fields and waves. The calculation of capacitance is one of the prime important. We know very well the capacitor plays a vital role in developing any circuits, most probably for frequency generation, filtering. This role for capacitor. So if you start a capacitor, what is the application of capacitors? Frequency generation, that is tank circuit. And second one is frequency generation, and we can store the charge carrier. And provide filtering. I think filtering, low pass filter, any filter you can use it, you can any kind of filters. And finally, use lead, the phase component. This is completely under an electrical department. By using the capacitor, they want to make the power factor correction. So these are all the main part of the capacitor. So how the capacitors look like? In my lectures, first of all, I will tell what is the application first. Then we are explaining the architecture and how it is in mathematical expression. That is my way of teaching. So first, the title, what is we are going to title is spherical capacitor. So this is the title. We are going to derive what is the spherical capacitor value. Before that, what is capacitor? So what is the application of, these are all the application of the capacitor application. So application of capacitor is frequency generated, store the charge in carrier and filtering, and lead phase components. These are all the capacitor applications. How it is look like? The capacitor architecture, the two conducting mediums. The two conducting mediums are separated by some specific dielectric medium. Wherever I am shading, these are all dielectric medium. These are all conducting. So, the two conductors are filled with dielectric. Dielectric medium is simply an insulator. It's not passed any electricity. So that does it. Normally, the types of capacitors are called as YAR capacitor, and you can say the glass capacitor, and mica capacitor, and we can. So what is the medium we are using in between the two? There's a two parallel places. Send the dielectric medium maybe YAR or gloss or mica. So that depends upon that usage. The name of the capacitor is varying. What is the capacitor symbol? The symbol of capacitor is simply a two parallel lines. So this is a symbol of capacitor. If it is electrolytic capacitor, that is, it should be some this slanted line. If it is variable, we know very well, we use some arrow mark. So these are the capacitor symbols what we know. Right. So now come to the point about how to calculate the capacitor. Mathematical expression. So what is capacitor? How to calculate? C is equal to Q by V. So what is it? C is a capacitor, Q is a charge of the capacitor. It may be a line charge or volume charge, depends upon what kind of medium we are using. V is a potential, so it is a charge, and V is a potential or voltage, and V is a capacitance. Capacitance value is preferred as farad. Most probably it's microfarad and nanofarad because of low values only the capacitor will be used. This is the prime formula to calculate what is C by Q by V. In terms of architecture, we can say C is equal to epsilon A by D. It says that C is directly proportional to area and inversely proportional to the distance between the plates. So here, this is called the distance D. Some of the author may use D instead of W also. With also they can use. So students, you must know that's D. That represents this parameter is nothing but the difference between the two plates. So the capacitance is C epsilon A by V. This is all the methodology how to calculate the capacitor. Now we come to the point spherical capacitor. If the capacitor arrangement is in terms of spherical, here we can say the capacitor arrangement in terms of cube. The capacitors, the charges are distributed in a spherical manner. How to derive the formula, how to get the formula, that is what we are going to do right now. So assume that spherical capacitor. Assume that this is a charge which is distributed around a sphere and we are taking a Gaussian surface. Already I told that if you want to calculate the electric field intensity, we must use the Gaussian surface. I think the previous lectures what we have, that is Gauss law. The Gauss law says that Gaussian surface. We use that this is close to Gaussian surface. So it's contained some dielectric medium. This is the first ring is the first metallic layer. And the second one is the second metallic layer. In between, it is filled with dielectric medium. So we have two radius. This is A and this is B. So if the charge is, assume that the charge carriers inside is plus. The charge carrier inside the metal region is called as plus. Then automatically what is the charge is inducing is that the negative charge is induced on the remaining medium. So this is negative charge is induced. So this is now is acting like a capacitor. Now we are going to derive what is the how to calculate the capacitance value in this arrangement. So before going to that, in this Gaussian surface, we must know what is the electric field. E is equal to what? Q divided by 4 pi epsilon r squared. This is called Q. So E is equal to what? The electric field is equal to the number of charge carrier, the Q, divided by 4 pi epsilon r squared. So this is E. If you want to calculate V, why we need V? Because we need, what is, how to calculate the capacitance? Q by V. So we need V. So V is what? V is a potential. Potential means, what is the definition of potential is there? It is the integral of E dot dl. E dot dl. So this dl, here this E dot ar into ar vector, because E vector, this is A vector. So E dot dl, that means that, see here infinity to r, but in this case we can then get the two values, that is V to A. What is potential is there? The charge carriers are moved from one place to another place. Work done by the charge carriers called potential. What is work done? For example, so if this is the duster, what I am having? Work done means I am applying a force. Automatically what will happen? It will move some distance. So this is the point. This is the charge. Assume that this is the charge carrier. My electric field is moving this charge carrier to this particular point. What happened? The electric charge carriers are moved from this point to this point. So this is called as work done by the charge carrier. That is known as the potential of the charge carrier. So we come to here. So whatever we see, so E is a force, electric flux, and dl is a charge. So what is dl here? So dl is dl vector here, dr is the dr vector, dr is a magnet, total radius r, So total radius r. We are taking the radius here, the Gaussian surface. We are taking the radius here. This is r. The Gaussian surface we are taking r. What is the unit vector across this one? As dr. So we can make now. We want to calculate b. Why we want to calculate b? Because c is equal to what? Q by b. Q already is there. If we calculate b means definitely we can apply it here. See the capacitance value we can calculate. That's the reason we want to calculate b here. So please remember that. So what is e? Already we know. So minus integral of b to a q divided by 4 pi epsilon r square a r vector dot b r a r vector. If it is the dot product, automatically the unit vector gets, because what is it in dot product? A r vector dot a r vector is equal to 1. If same vector with the dot product, the value will become 1. So if you do that, this value becomes 1. So what we get here, so v is equal to minus integral v to a q divided by 4 pi epsilon r square into dr. So this is the integral with respect to dr. So what are the component here is 4 pi epsilon. So we can say that minus q divided by 4 pi epsilon integral b to a, that is 1 pi r square dr. If it is 1 pi r square, what is the formula? So r power n is equal to, if you integrate, r power n is equal to r power n minus 1 divided by, sorry, n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. This is the general power formula of any integral. So here r power minus 2, r power minus 2 means what? R power minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1, which result R power minus 1 divided by minus 1. R power minus 1 is what? R power minus 1 is here what? 1 by R minus 1 is equal to minus 1. So the total integral of this function is 1 minus 1 by R. The total integral of this function is what? Minus 1 by R. So we will get the definition. So what we get, we are calculating v. So v is equal to minus q by 4 by epsilon, 1 by r is integrated, after that we get minus 1 by r. This minus minus get plus, therefore q dot of by 4 by epsilon r, the limit is equal to v. So the answer is 1 by b upper limit minus lower limit 1 by a. So what is b here is q divided by 4 pi epsilon 1 by b. 1 by b minus 1 by a. So this is b. What is c? C is equal to q by b. Q already we know what is. Q is q and b. What is b? Q divided by 4 pi epsilon 1 by b minus 1 by a. Right. So if you do that, we'll get c. We are calculating c now. So q should get cancelled. So 1, 4 pi epsilon divided by 4 pi epsilon into 1 by b, 1 by a. This is the capacitance value. This is the capacitance value in terms of value. So this is the capacitance value of spherical capacitor. Suppose the spherical capacitor, the value is, like spherical capacitor value A becomes infinity, it will come from infinity, means anything divided by infinity is zero. Therefore C divided by 4 pi epsilon pi B. So this becomes B. So this is the capacitor value when it is come. So what we conclude is, we start with the capacitor, what is capacitor, type of capacitor, mathematical expression, and what is the value of mathematical and spherical capacitor, how the derivation of spherical capacitor. This is that, it shows that it is depends upon the radius of second one and epsilon value, it is epsilon. So the capacitor value depends upon the radius of the second capacitance value. That is the main conclusion of this function. So I hope you can get very good idea about this, how the spherical capacitor to derive and what is the use of capacitor. Thank you.